Jen Chien gave us a video chat tour of her Wuhan apartment. It only took a few seconds to show us the small space where she has spent the past 20-plus days, unable to leave her home as part of the latest Wuhan lockdown measures.
Since the lockdown, I've been really rationing my food so it will last longer.
The local government has allowed for grocery delivery, but Gui Jen fears opening her windows and doors could mean exposure to the novel coronavirus. She's not only protecting her own health, but also that of her 2-year-old granddaughter, Felicity.
I'm looking after this baby, and the floors above and below me have confirmed coronavirus cases.
Felicity is a U.S. citizen. Gui Jen's been raising her granddaughter as the little girl's parents are living and working in New York City. But amid the outbreak and extreme lockdown, Felicity's mother is desperately trying to get the pair out of Wuhan.
I'm afraid I cannot see my daughter again. I think if they are infected, I think they will be dead.
Fearing the worst, Amanda Zhang is pleading with the U.S. Embassy to grant her mother-in-law, a Chinese citizen, a visa so she can accompany the toddler back to the U.S. In the meantime, she has started stockpiling supplies in her New York City apartment, hoping to ship them to Wuhan.
We want to send all these masks to my families, to my relatives, and donate some to the hospitals.
But she has struggled to find a carrier to deliver within the lockdown zone. There are similar fears and frustrations shared by other Hubei province residents.
And now we are totally blocked. There's no person allowed to go out.
By phone, Wendy Young told us that she was on day 27 or 28 inside her apartment. She started to lose count. She sent us photos from her window looking out. She says she feels trapped and depressed.
So many people pass away in these long days, and we all suffering.
Back inside Gui Jen's apartment, the 61-year-old admits she's relied on cartoons to help keep Felicity entertained.
If it wasn't for Peppa Pig, there'd be no way I could look after her.
But there's an added fear for Gui Jen. She says she's also battling thyroid cancer and worries she might be more susceptible to contracting the coronavirus.
If I get sick with this pneumonia, I have no idea what I would do with this child.
CNN has been in touch with the U.S. Embassy here in China about that particular case. They tell us they're aware of the situation, but the reality is things are far more complicated than just simply getting the grandmother and her grandchild on a flight out of here. I mean, there's a lot of logistics working not only within the city of Wuhan, but also in coordination with the Chinese government. Meantime, the U.S. has gotten some 800 plus of its citizens on 5 separate flights back to the United States. All in all, though, there seems to be a fear that is really shared amongst many of the folks we have talked to who feel trapped in the city of Wuhan. David Culver, CNN, Shanghai.